Good evening, and welcome to Millennium Stage. Now, please give a warm welcome to musicians from the National Symphony Orchestra.
A quick announcement that we won't be playing today for time constraints, the Open the Kingdom by Philip Glass, so we'll be moving on to the Quattro Stanzas Sibyllinis. And this is by Eduardo Angulo, who is a living Mexican composer, born in 1954 in Puebla, Mexico. And He studied violin and entered the conservatory in Mexico City at the age of 7, and actually later went on to graduate from the Royal Conservatory in Hague, and studied both composition and violin. And he's a well-known, prolific Mexican composer of symphonic pieces, chamber music, and choral works. And his style of writing, well, actually, Cuatro Danzas Sibilinas, it translates something like four mysterious dances. And his style is, of writing is very romantic and joyful. The first movement is the Adagio, and it's just a very beautiful melody which he expands upon. The second movement is the Andante, and that begins with the alto flute, and it's almost march-like sounding. It's very whimsical. The third and the fourth movement are actually very, very much traditional huapangos, which came from Mexican folk and dance music. And if you don't know exactly what huapangos are, it's alternating rhythms from two to three, and the most probably well-known American huapango is America from West Side Story. And so that's been used throughout music, more recent music, Mexican folk music. And the third and the fourth movement are very different huapangos. The third movement is a beautiful melodic work with alternating rhythms, but the fourth movement is a more brilliant, exciting work using the same type of rhythm. And it's always nice to discover a new composer. I hope you enjoy this piece.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. next piece by Maurice Ravel was originally written for solo piano, the Minuet Antique. It was premiered in 1898 and was orchestrated in 1929. Ravel was only 23 years old when he composed this work. And I think you'll hear his fascination with music of the Baroque era and how it was put together. I think I particularly enjoy the unexpected kind of spicy harmonies, which give it kind of a Spanish flair. The Canadian harpist Jocelyn Morlock arranged it for flute, harp, and viola many years later. Hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. The last piece we're going to play tonight is by a living composer, Stephen Mean, who lives out in the San Francisco Bay Area. And it's really exciting as a trio to have living composers that we can communicate with and understand what their music is and what they want us to portray as we play the piece. So I've been in touch with this composer several times over the summer and have been lucky enough to get responses back from him. And the piece, Columbus, is named after the trio that commissioned the piece. They live in Columbus, Ohio, so that's the easy part. The triptych part, if we go back to our art history classes, if you'll remember, a triptych is a panel of artwork, usually on a piece of wood and connected by hinges. Usually there are three pieces to this art piece. And each separate wood panel is its own picture, but it's really meant to be viewed in its entirety, all three panels together. And he wanted to portray that in the music that he wrote. So this piece is written in three movements, but all of the thematic material is connected together. And it's really neat. The piece slows down in between movements, but we connect right one into the other. So what you hear in the first movement, you'll also hear in the second and third, but it will sound very different. But I hope you enjoy this last piece, and we're just so honored and thrilled to have the chance to present it here today. We'd also, before we play our last piece, like to thank you so much for coming out to hear us play today. We love to perform, it's a lot of fun, and we can't do it without an audience. So thank you so much for sharing your evening with us and being our audience and letting us share our music with you.
Thank you.
Joining us at the Millennium Stage. For more information about upcoming Millennium Stage